Let us study a very important phenomena in time-varying magnetic fields, which we call eddy currents. About eddy currents, we can write down that these are localized currents induced in a metal body due to relative motion between a metal body and a magnetic field. To understand eddy currents, let's have an example of the basic electromagnetic induction. Let's look on this picture. Here there exists an inward magnetic field which is into the plane of paper, and there is a wire loop ABCD placed. Now in this situation, if this wire loop is pulled toward right with a speed V, we can see the wires AB and CD are not cutting any magnetic flux. So no EMF will be induced in wires AB and CD, but this wire DA will be cutting magnetic flux, and an EMF will be induced in such a way that the point A will be at high potential, D will be at low potential. This direction we have calculated by using right-hand palm rule. We already discussed in the previous section. Now, in this situation, when the loop is pulled out, this wire AD behaves like an EMF, and due to which a current induces in the loop, because this is a closed path for the current to flow. If these wires AB, BC and CD are not present, then only EMF would have been induced. No current will flow through the circuit. If circuit is closed, there is a closed path for current available for its flow, the current will start flowing. And here you can see, if the current starts flowing, this wire DA will experience an opposing force BIL. This also verifies Lenz's law that if the loop is pulled out, the EMF is induced in such a way that the effects of the EMF will oppose the causes of induction. Here the cause is its motion. And you can see this magnetic force BIL on the wire DA will be opposing its motion. Now, similarly, we can have another example to directly understand the concept of eddy current by using this example. Let's have a look on this picture. In this picture, you can see if we are given with a solid metal sheet which is placed in a uniform magnetic field. Here, the magnetic field is directed into the plane of this paper. And say with the magnetic field we tie a string and a force F is applied onto it, the sheet will start moving in outward direction with the speed V. Obviously, due to the force, the speed will increase. Now, in this situation, you can see the portion of sheet which is lying within the magnetic field. At every point, if we consider a virtual rod within the sheet, this rod is cutting the magnetic flux. So, at every point here, we can see if there are different rods, an EMF will be induced in individual rods. Now, in this situation, you can see this is a solid metal sheet. So, a current starts flowing in this manner in a random path. There is no fixed path. Like in the previous example, you can see this was a wire loop. So, current was flowing through the wire loop which was closed. Here also, current is getting closed path, but there are infinite closed paths from the region which is within the magnetic field to the region which is outside the magnetic field. So, there are such infinite closed paths developed in which there are infinite small localized currents are started from the region which is within magnetic field, where every element of the sheet will behave like an EMF, and the other side of the sheet which is outside the magnetic field will act like a region which is providing the closed path for the current to flow. Now, all such localized current, you can imagine whether the current is large or it is small. Basically, the currents will be very small, large currents will not flow because large path implying large resistance. And if smaller paths are available, we can directly state currents will flow in the smallest possible path. So, these all currents we call eddy currents. These are localized currents which exist within the metal body And just for example, I have drawn these large paths, but practically such large paths will never be taken over by the eddy currents. Only very small paths are taken closer to the boundary as well as within the magnetic field. But mainly it is closer to the boundary and a smaller path just because the resistance in the smaller paths will be relatively less. So most of the currents will flow through the smaller paths. So eddy currents are very small localized current within the volume of the solid metal body if there exists a relative motion between the body and the magnetic field. Here we can write down a note to understand better about eddy currents, that eddy currents have two major effects on the situation of the system in which eddy currents are being produced. The very first one is heat dissipation. If localized currents are flowing within the metal body, we can say due to Joule heating effect, continuous heat will be produced, or which will be radiated out from the metal body, and the metal body gets heat up. And the second effect which we have studied in this example is breaking action on motion of conductor or magnetic field. Because here you can see within the region of magnetic field, eddy currents are in upward direction. So at every eddy current, there will be a magnetic force, FMBIL sort of force will be acting. And due to the overall effect of eddy currents, we can see the external motion which is provided to the conductor or magnetic field, as we are talking about it, the relative motion between the two. This magnetic force will always oppose the external effects because of which the relative motion exists. So, which we call breaking action of motion of on motion of conductor or magnetic field. These are the two major effects of eddy currents. Soon we'll see about different cases of eddy currents also. Let's continue with one more example of eddy current. Let us continue with one more example to understand eddy current and its effects. Say we are given with a solid disk which is rotating about its center at an angular speed omega, and this is a solid metal disk. Now in this situation, say if in a circular region an inward magnetic field is switched on. Here we can see those sections of the metal disk which are within this magnetic field are moving in leftward direction. So we can say every small segment within the region of magnetic field will be acting like a conductor which is moving toward left. And due to which we can see an EMF is induced with the high potential at the lower end and low potential at the upper end. And due to this complete solid metal disk, there are infinite closed paths available. So here we can see due to the induction of EMF within this region, we can say at every point in the upper half of circle, it will be at low potential, and every point in the lower half of the circle where magnetic field is applied, high potential EMF will be induced. And in this situation, due to the closed paths, here you can see currents starts flowing in this manner. The currents will exist in this situation in such a way that current will be originated in the lower region and it will be going within the magnetic field from upward to downward path, and in outside region this is getting closed path like this. This is the way how several eddy currents are induced. Here you can see eddy currents are induced just because of motion of conductor in a steady magnetic field. And at every point within the region where magnetic field is applied, you can see the current exists in inward direction. So in this situation, the density of current will be maximum within this region, as an outside region it is distributed. So here we can see within the region of this magnetic field, due to current's flow, a rightward magnetic force will experience at every eddy current which is within the loop. outside the loop also currents are there, but no magnetic field is there. So no opposite magnetic force will act. And this magnetic force will exert a torque on the disc with respect to its axis of rotation, which is opposing this omega. So you can see, due to this magnetic force, the value of omega will start decreasing. And this phenomena we call magnetic braking. That is, even if on a smooth axis of rotation, smooth axle, a disc is rotating, if it is made up of metal, a uniform magnetic field is applied onto it. Due to eddy currents, heat starts dissipating within this region. Actually, the heat is coming from the kinetic energy of rotation of this disc. So, its kinetic energy starts decreasing due to this opposing force. Or you can say, this is the opposing force which is transforming mechanical energy into thermal dissipation. So, this is the way by which the disc will have a braking action due to eddy currents. Let's have a look on this realistic situation where we can see there is a real disc, metal disc, which is rotating about its axis of rotation. And here you can see, if a uniform magnetic field is applied in a cylindrical region on a section of this disc, like we have discussed here, braking action starts and you can see the value of angular speed starts decreasing. If we just have a closer look on the top view of this situation, here you can see the phenomena is the same. Due to magnetic field and motion of conductor, eddy currents are produced, and due to eddy currents, an opposite magnetic force starts acting at various points within the region of magnetic field on the metal disc. And due to the torque of this force, omega is decreasing, and after some time the disc will come to rest. This is the phenomena which we call magnetic braking.